Hello, respected. Thanks for opening the right video for lymphatic system. Do you know, our body has 10 times more bacterial cells than total cells of our body. Amazing. Most are friend bacteria, but few are enemies. It's surprising that when we are alive, they are our friends. But as soon our homeostasis stops after death, these friends turn to enemies and start eating our body. Moreover, we are constantly exposed to external microbes through food, water, air and touch. So, to deal with dangers, we must have a mechanism of check and balance to get rid of these enemies as well protection for future. The system which do all this in our bodies is lymphatic system. Let's understand the structure and functions of lymphatic system today. Keep watching to gain full insights. In 1882, a Russian zoologist, Ali Mechnikov, discovered cells which have defensive roles in the body, and he gave the name phagocytes. The name phagocyte is still in use. This system of body is immune system, the system which lack organ system level but have only populations of cells that defend the body against pathogens. These immune cells are present in whole of the body, but they are rich in a true organ system, the lymphatic system, the system which we shall learn today. Lymphatic system is a network of tubes that is spread in nearly all tissues of body and is consisted of tissue and organs which produce immune cells. Among these organs and tissues are lymph nodes, thymus, spleen, tonsils and red bone marrow. Main functions of lymphatic system are fluid recovery from the body, providing immunity and lipid absorption from the tissue fluid. Before diving into the details, let's understand structures and components of lymphatic system so that we may understand the functions easily. Main components of lymphatic system are lymph, the collected fluid, lymphatic vessels which transport lymph, lymphatic tissues which are collection of lymphocytes and macrophages in different organs. The fourth one, lymphatic organs. These are houses rich in lymphatic cells surrounded by connective tissues to protect the surroundings. Now, what is lymph? The first question. Lymph is basically a clear and colorless fluid, low in proteins, collected by vessels from tissue fluid. Composition of lymph is different in different places and in different times. For example, when small intestine is filled with food, the collected lymph is milky due to lipids, large amount of lipids. After passing from lymph nodes, this lymph may have hormones, bacteria, macrophages, viruses, debris and cancer cells as well. Do you know the difference between lymph and blood? If not, let's have a brief overview today. Lymph is a colorless fluid while blood is red, you know, hemoglobin. Lymph provides defense while blood transports materials from one organ to another in the body, whole body. Lymph doesn't have red blood cells while blood has red blood cells. See? Similarly, lymph is low oxygen while blood has very high oxygen in oxygenated form. Lymph lack proteins, or you can say very low amount of proteins present in the lymph, while blood have many kinds of proteins, the plasma as well as absorbed proteins. Similarly, lymph clot very slowly while blood clot very quickly, and the flow of lymph is unidirectional from tissue fluid to the subclavian vein, while the circulation in the blood is circulatory kind and it is continuously circulating in two different circuits, from the heart to body and from heart to lungs and again back to the heart. So hope the difference between lymph and blood is clear now. Let's talk about the second component of lymphatic system, the vessels. Second component of lymphatic system is lymph vessel. These vessels are like blood vessels and also called lymphatics. The route of lymph is from lymphatic capillaries to collecting vessels and to six lymphatic trunks, to two collecting ducts and finally to subclavian ovine. This circulation makes sure the recycling of fluid from tissue to blood and from blood to tissue fluid, performing check and balance of body fluid always. Capillaries. Lymphatic vessels begin from lymphatic capillaries, which are present in every part of body except cornea of eye, bone, cartilage and bone marrow. Other than, unlike blood capillaries, lymphatic capillaries are closed at one end. Lymphatic capillaries are consisted of sacs of endothelial cells lying one another. These endothelial cells are not packed but have pores in between the cells through which bacteria, lymphocytes and other particles can enter the capillaries along with fluid. Check the diagram of lymph capillary on the right side. You can observe that overlapping endothelial cells have pores and they are open and closed based on pressure. Pressure helps the flaps of endothelial cells to open and close. Like when pressure outside is higher, they open, and when inside is higher, they are closed like valves. The next component is collecting vessels. Lymph capillaries join to form collecting vessels. These vessels run parallel with veins and arteries. These collecting vessels irregularly empty into lymph nodes slowly, where bacteria are phagocytized and cells perform a check for foreign antigens. Lymph nodes are box-like structures enriched with variety of cells which have specific functions, and many phagocytes float randomly to detect any harmful antigen or bacteria. Lymph enters from several efferent ducts and leaves through fewer efferent ducts through the node to make sure that it stays inside for a while. Remember that such nodes are present throughout body and each part of body deal independently of other. After passing through lymph nodes, the fluid again enters collecting vessels, and same process may be repeated afterwards when reaching to another node. In the human diagram, you can observe many nodes present in each vessel throughout the body. These nodes are the true checkpoints for defense and immunity, as well as factories of phagocytes. Lymphatic trunks. The collecting vessels then converge to larger vessels called lymphatic trunks, as in diagram. There are six lymphatic trunks, namely jugular, subclavian, bronchomediastinal, intercostal, intestinal and lumbar. Intestinal trunk is single and all others are paired. Large ducts. These trunks empty into largest lymphatic collecting ducts, the right lymphatic duct and thoracic duct. Right lymphatic duct collects fluid from right jugular, bronchomediastinal and subclavian, while thoracic duct on left is larger and longer and collect lymph from left bronchomediastinal, left subclavian, left jugular and rest of the body. Thoracic duct may be called as left lymphatic duct. One thing to note here is that lumbar trunk and intestinal trunk joins to form a sac called as cisterna chyli. Chyl is the intestinal fat rich lymph after eating food. So in simple words, thoracic duct receives lymph from all parts lower than diaphragm and left arm, left head, neck and thorax. How lymph moves in body when there is no heart to pump it? Lymphatic system has no heart. So how fluid moves in vessels? The answer is rhythmic contraction of lymphatic vessels. When vessels are filled, they contract to push the fluid forward. I'm talking about the lymphatic vessels. Walls prevent the backflow. Similarly, skeletal muscles present around the vessels help in the movement of lymph like veins. We know now that lymph vessels are connected with arteries through same sheath. So when arteries contract, they also help to in the contraction of the lymphatic vessels to push the lymph forward. One important thing is the inhalation and exhalation, which also help to push the fluid, like the movement of diaphragm upward and downward is the key in the movement of lymph. So having good exercise daily helps to move and refresh the lymph in our body. Flow of lymph makes us lazy and active. That's my opinion. If lymph vessels are filled and we are sleeping, then we shall feel laziness. But if we do exercise and lymph moves in vessels and they become lower in pressure, we feel activeness. That's the reason we should do exercise regularly with muscle stretching.